salvation.
Lord, hear my prayer.
Let my prayer be answered.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, send the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ saith, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it, thou shalt love thy neighbour as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets.
Mercy, O Lord, have mercy on us. under this most holy night, with the beams of thy one true love, grant, we beseech, that he who have known the mystery of this light on earth may also attain to the fullness of his joys in heaven. Through the same Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost, ever one God, world without end.
Salvation hath appeared to all men, teaching us that, denying ungodliness and worldly lust, we should live soberly, righteously, and godly in the present world, looking for that blessed hope and the glorious appearing of the great God and our Savior, Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us that he might redeem us from all iniquity and purify unto himself a peculiar people, zealous of good works. These things speak and exhort and rebuke with all authority. Let no man despise thee. Hear and listen.
Thanks be to God.
Wife, being great with child. And And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God, and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men.
To be born among us for our salvation. And I'm not going to preach, so forgive me if I rattle on, but it's just such a wonderful and a beautiful feast, and it's so great to see so many people here. Come again when it's not so crowded, come again and make it crowded again. But I just want to welcome you all, each and every one of you. I want to thank all the people who have made this such a beautiful mass, the singers and the servers and the altar guild, and all the people who make this team's number give something beautiful to the Lord our God. And now, without further ado, let me shut up and hand over to the Father.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Amen. Amen.
There are two Christmas stories. You may not have thought about that, but there are. The first one is about a child born in a backwater area of the Roman Palestine area, and his name was Jesus. He grew up and became a famous prophet. His teachings spread throughout the world. He had an impact on a worldwide impact in many ways. And his teachings are things that are followed by many people to this day. History does not question the reality of the birth of Jesus in Nazareth. I don't think any historian at this stage of the game would quibble about that, the reality of that birth. That's the first story. The second story is about a child born in a backwater area in Roman Palestine, and 2,000 years ago. And that child was both God and man. Now, that seems impossible, because it doesn't make any sense. You know, I've taught many years at the university level, and I used to tell the students, it's the most ridiculous story I could ever come up with. This woman gets pregnant, gives birth to a child, and the child is both man and God. Incredible. Incredible. The second story is not at all like the first story because there's no historical basis that we can point to and say, yeah, well, you know, pretty well proves it. Because you don't prove a matter of faith. You don't prove a matter of faith. The first story is something that is inspiring. It's wonderful. It goes along with a lot of other aspiring and historic stories. But the second story is something entirely different. It's a story that is involved in a timeless event that is an ongoing thing that we participate in today. You know, the first story was an event that took place in time, and that's it. The second story does not end 2,000 years ago. It continues right down to us tonight. Because Christ is born as an ongoing experience for each and every one of us. As we gather here tonight and we celebrate this event, we're celebrating something that's not just what happened 2,000 years ago. It's what is happening on a constant basis. Because Christ is born within us. I see Christ in you. And I hope that you see Christ in me. Because the presence of Christ, the ever-living, eternal Son of God, that presence is not absent from the world. That presence lives on with us as we continue our lives now. And it's important for us to remember that, because that Spirit of Christ is within us and is there for a purpose, for other people to see Christ in you and in me. It's a responsibility that you take if you take the name Christian. Because if you call yourself a Christian, you have to ask, what does that mean? And it means something more than just an event that took place 2,000 years ago. It means something that is living, dynamic, powerful. The holy, profound love of God. That love permeates. That love purifies. That love brings us wholeness, joy, and peace. And without that, it's just another story. Now, it's a matter of faith. We have to believe in these things. And you know, in a way, it'd be nice if we could just say, oh yeah, you know, it's taken care of. We know it. It's true. Well, we believe it's true. And that word belief is important. Because if it were just something that we could take for granted, if it was an event that history would verify like that first story does, that'd be easy. That would be easy. It wouldn't amount to much. Because things that are easy never really amount to much. It's the things that we have to struggle with. Things that are hard. It's hard to be a Christian. It's hard to take this, what I'm saying, seriously. It's hard to walk out of here feeling the presence of Christ and knowing you have an obligation to let that presence of Christ show in you. It's not easy. But then, he never promised that. And you think what he gave up, what little sacrifices we have to make, don't amount to very much, all things considered. But that second story, that powerful story, is what we are about tonight. We're here to celebrate and to take joy in the reality that Christ is born. I say is, not was. Christ is born, and we celebrate him. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Amen. Let us stand and proclaim this very faith.
Amen.
is that your sacrifice and mine made acceptable to God and the Almighty Father.
May the Lord receive this sacrifice at thy hands, to the praise and glory of his name, both to our benefit and that of all his holy church.
Amen. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's church. O Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle hast taught us to make prayer supplication and intercession for all, to give thanks for all, we humbly beseech thee by pleasure to extend our arms and oblations and receive these our prayers, which we offer up unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord, and grant that all those who confess thy holy name may live in me. Thy holy name, we both agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godliness. We beseech thee also so direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers, that they may truly and impartially administer justice to the punishment of wickedness and vice and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace also to all bishops and other ministers, especially some of our metropolitan, and to the that they may both by their life and doctrine set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, especially to this congregation, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. We also bless thy holy name for all thy servants who part this life in thy faith and fear, that they may both, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to give us grace so to follow the good example of Blessed Mary and of all thy saints, that through their intercessions we with them may be made partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant us, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate.
Amen.
Ye who do truly and earnestly repent of your sins and in love and charity with your neighbors, and intend to lead a new life for following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith, and take this holy sacrament to your comfort, and make your humble confession unto Almighty God, give earthly meaning. Almighty God,
Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and beware of our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty, provoking most just and gratified indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and our heart is sorry for these unstewards, the remembrance of them is grievous unto us, the burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us, have mercy upon us, most merciful God, for thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may under our house serve and be seated in this life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, with great mercy, I promise to give sins to all those with heart repentance and through faith now to him. Have mercy upon me, pardon and deliver from all your sins, confirm and strengthen in all goodness, and bring you everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear our comfortable words, our Saviour Christ saith to all who truly turn to him. Come unto me, all ye that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. He also was St. Paul said, this is a true saying, and worthy of all to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. He also was St. John said, if anyone sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up be assured in all times and in all places. Give thanks unto thee, O Lord, every heart, almighty everlasting God. Because through the mystery of the word made flesh, the light of thy glory hath shone upon the eyes of our man, that as we acknowledge God made visible to men, we may through him be caught up into the love of things invisible. And therefore with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we Lord and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, after supper he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it, in remembrance of me. Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, to celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty, with these thy gifts and presents which we offer up unto thee, the sacrifice which thy Son, Jesus Christ, hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech you, merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness, vouchsafe to send down thy Holy Spirit upon these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that they may be changed into the body and blood of thy most dearly beloved Son. Grant that we receiving them according to the saying, thy Son Jesus Christ, our Savior's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may we be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness, mercy to
who accept this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseech you to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ. And through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain the remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer to present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls, and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and may one body with him, that he may dwell in us and in him. Be mindful, O Lord, also thy servants who have gone before us with a sign of faith, and who now rest in the sleep of peace. We beseech you, O Lord, that unto them, and unto all such as rest in Christ, thou wilt grant a place of refreshment, of light, and of peace. To us sinners also, thy servants, vouchsafe in the mouth of thy mercies to grant some lot and portion with thy holy apostles and martyrs, John, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucia, Annie, Cecilia, Anastasia, and with all thy saints, into whose company we pray thee thy mercy with us. And although we are unworthy from manifold sins to offer up unto thee sacrifice, yet we beseech you to take this our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offences, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. By whom and with whom in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto your Father Almighty, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray. And now the Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Lord.
cross and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be clean by his blood, and our soul washed through his precious blood, and have you never forgotten him and in us.
Lord, I know when. Lord, I know when. Lord, I know when. Behold the Lamb of God.
Behold him who takes away the sins of the world.
Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof.
But speak word only, my soul shall be healed.
Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof.
But speak word only, my soul shall be healed.
Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof.
But speak word only, my soul shall be healed.
In respect of the discipline of the Orthodox Church, we ask that only communicant Orthodox who are properly prepared receive Holy Communion. But please, if you are not Orthodox or if you're not prepared, please do come and receive a blessing and also to partake of the blessed bread. I believe, O Lord, and I confess
that thou art truly the Christ, the Son of the living God, who didst come into the world to save sinners, of whom I am chief. I believe that this is truly my own precious body, and this is truly my own precious blood. Wherefore I pray thee, have mercy upon me, and forgive my transgressions, both voluntary and involuntary, of word and of deed, of knowledge and ignorance, and make me worthy to partake without condemnation of thy immaculate mysteries, unto the remission of my sins, and to life everlasting.
Preserve thy body and soul, and everlasting life. The
Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, be forgiven for thee, thy body and soul, is everlasting. Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, be forgiven for thee, preserve thy body and soul, and everlasting. Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, be forgiven for thee, preserve thy body and soul, and everlasting. Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, be forgiven for thee, preserve thy body and soul, and everlasting. Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, forgiven for thee, preserve thy body and soul, and everlasting life. Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, forgiven for thee,
heart we thank thee. The Son has vouchsafed to feed us, whenever we receive his holy spirit. The spirit of food and water for all God, of thy Son and our Savior Jesus Christ, and thus to show us thereby of thy faith and ministers for us, and that we are made again to listen to our written and mystical life of thy Son, which is the best company of all faithful people, and also heirs to the hope of the everlasting kingdom, by the merits of his most precious heir and our passion. And we humbly beseech you, Heavenly Father, so that those sisters of thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship, and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom we hear and the Holy Ghost, to your honor and glory.
Thanks be to God.